Dennis has strived over the years to keep the gym as busy as he can, and as I said, I've been fortunate enough to come into this gym this year, and the gym's got big numbers that come in, even in the little toddlers class. You know, we get 40, 50 kids in that, and then we've got the senior class, we get 50 odd in that. So most nights we're taking 100 kids off the street from the ages of 8 to 9, right the way through to the age of 27. You're early, aren't you? It's a busy gym and it's done really well, and I think a gym like this needs that support from the community, so we can pay the bills and obviously pay for the equipment, because everything here is voluntary, no one gets paid for nothing, and we don't have money to buy bags, so you know, we haven't been fortunate enough to get many grants to buy equipment, so hopefully in the future, you know, it'll come around and we'll get our share.
It shows you know, the amount of kids you're getting in here from the local area. It shows there's a real cause for it and, you know, a need for it.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's one of the most deprived areas in Britain. Well, in Europe, apparently. So, and I think we're doing a great job. Yeah. Everyone here involved with this gym is doing a fantastic job taking all these kids off the street. You know, if it's for 2 hours a night, by the time the kids have finished training, they're going to go home and they're shattered and they'll stay in and they won't go out and get into trouble on the streets. We teach them discipline. And the parents of you come in and say they can't believe the difference in the kids once they've trained in the gym.
You know, other than, obviously it's not easy to keep a club running on subs and things like that. You know, how do you finance it? Do you have sponsors or support?
Well, no, we don't have any sponsors for the actual gym, but what we do is we do a lot of fundraising ourselves. You know, Sean and a couple of other coaches done a marathon, you know, a full marathon, and they earned a few thousand quid in the gym. But you know, as you know yourself, with that many volume of kids coming through and using the equipment, we're obviously using the equipment quicker because it's wearing out quicker because there's more people using it. These are the things that we're struggling with. Well, at the minute, we've just, a guy just come along and said he'll sponsor the gym for equipment and kits and that. And hopefully, fingers crossed, that'll happen. It's tag development for us. So we're just waiting for them to come back to us in the next couple of weeks. You remember this guy here, Noel Claus? He's from Liverpool. Big heavyweight. It might have even been cruiserweight. The other one, John Conti. The one here, Sean Sutton, from the gym. He's one of the coaches. The gym's been open for probably about 4 or 5 years now. It originally opened and got burnt down. As you can see, it's all been rebuilt now and things are looking a lot better. Sean and his dad Dennis have done a tremendous amount of work in the gym to get to where it is. I've been fortunate enough to come into the gym when it's in this condition, after all the hard work done. That's basically it about the gym, really.
What boxers have fought here and who have you got coming through?
Oh, we've got lots of seniors coming through. Obviously, Sean Dodd and Sean Lewis, they're the first pros that we've had in the gym. So it's got to be onwards and upwards for the rest of the guys who are following them on. Like. So they're an inspiration to everyone in the gym, really.
Danny was saying that, you know, to keep the gym going and yeah. You know, the need to keep it going with all the kids who come. Has it, you know, from your days, from the beginning, has it always been a struggle like that, to keep it going, finance and, you know, have that support?
It's got a bit easier now with the likes of Danny and the people, because we just relying on subs were keeping us going. We had no equipment, so that, you know, and as a local businessman bought us a ring, bought us some bags. Mr. Robbie Kendall, his name is, he bought us some equipment. But it's always been relying on getting the subs in, but as soon as the subs, if you're going anywhere taking lads boxing, we had no transport, so we have to pay fellas in cars to take us, so pay him the pet, give him his wages for the night and that, and so the subs you were getting in was going out. on expenses to go boxing, you know. So it's been a struggle for years and years. Really, well,
like,
really hard.
Gyms up and down the country, it's a real community effort, isn't it? To,
yeah,
you know, the real love, you know, inner core of the love of the sport.
But as Danny said, there's kids, the mothers have broken me, the parents, and like uncontrollable, really. But we have here the discipline. No swearing, no spitting, no chewing gum. And the parents have said, what's happened here? He said, he's behaving himself in the house. You know what I mean? He takes the discipline from here to the house, and to me, look, the parents, he can't believe it.
Well, that's what boxing does, isn't it?
But
gives
them that, you know,
discipline.
Yeah.
To respect each other and respect,
of course,
you know,
as
real human beings.
Yeah. I mean, even if you don't, box, the kids don't box, at least you're making them a good citizen, if you know what I mean, to behave themselves and out in the street, no bullying, and, you know, behaving themselves at home, no giving cheek to the parents and what have you, you know.
And this is the same, as you say, lots of gyms around the country, we're all in the same boat. It's a shame that we can't get funding regularly so that we can buy this equipment, you know, maybe even take the kids away for a week, you know, to I don't know, something like all of the camp where you can do like teamwork events and, you know, stuff like that. But, you know, we've just got to do our best at what we're doing at the minute. In the gym 7 days a week, working like we can and helping them out.
Well, I commend you guys anyway for the efforts that yous are doing, and long may it continue.
Cheers, Chris, I appreciate that. Thank you.
Like to them, Alec Powell, he lost his eye in the Gallipoli landings. He was and he's known all over the, and Hitler sent him a telegram to train the German youth. And he refused, because he lost his eye in the First World War. Boxing, you know, Alec Powell. They're schoolboy champions in Birkenhead in their era. Henry Lang, Freddie Wilkes, Vic Harrison, Charlie Tonner. Around the 50s, Bygraves, Wally Tom, Frankie Williams, Pat McCarthy, Tommy Keeley, Pat McAteer. That was the he trained all them men. Jerry Byrne, he's the old trainer. In that era of McAteer, Wally Tom, Pat McCarthy, Leo Malloy, the Liverpool Stadium was of all one side, Adobe Birkenhead places. You know, there was Johnny Campbell was the manager. You see, I've got it, we've got Johnny. There he is. He's the manager. There's Tom and McAteer going to spar, having a sparring session. He managed all them boxes. Johnny Campbell.
A lot of these you knew personally, yourself.
Oh, I knew. Well, he used to, be honest with you, he used to train me. He was my trainer, Alec Powell, when I was a kid, when I was boxing schoolboy.
Some special boxers up there, special guys.
Yeah, I knew all them. There's Leo Malloy, the Birkenhead lad. I'll tell me about that. Tommy Carey, there's Pat McAteer again. It's Charlie Smith, Billy Hughes, Kid Fogo, Mickey Flanagan, Bob Nelson.
The list goes on.
Oh, yeah. I knew all them personally.
Fantastic wall of pictures, yeah, it really is.
There's Peter McCann, yeah, God rest his soul. Don't even remember him. He was the first Birkenhead man to win an ABA title. 1968 he won his title.
How did you get involved in boxing yourself, Dennis?
When my father took me when I was a kid to the gym, and I haven't been out of the gym since. I've been here 36 years in this gym. Yeah, I've just... See, Alec Powell had a gym called the Queensway. And I was the only one who used to give me the keys to open up. When I was at school, I was only 12, I'd go down, open up, light the fire in the old great suit to warm the water for the lads that come in later on, so to get a shower, you know. But I had the keys when I was 12.
So you let them all, a lot of these guys in, a lot of them out, you know.
Yeah.
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 You've seen a few come through then, Dennis, over the years.
Yeah.
Who excites you at the moment coming through in the gym? Which boxers do you think, you know, have got what it takes to maybe have a picture on that wall one day?
Well, Massey will get on. I'd put him on Massey. Young Hampson, who just went out, he won the ABA title on Sunday, that young kid. Freddie Young, he's a schoolboy, right? He's won two, but he's got four national titles. And he got them when he was only 13. He's just won the schoolboys again this year. So he's boxing the Tri-Nations. He won the Tri-Nations last year. So he's unbeaten at the schoolboys. So got great expectations of him, you know. There's some great kids coming through here. All times, they're getting good. Like the Danny Arshaw and the coaches, you know, they're getting good coaching.
Lace up your gloves, you're a fighting man. Lay down your soul on the line. Embrace your victory, the fallen. They're you from another time. Lace up your gloves, you're a pugilist. Born and raised to survive. Sweat, blood and tears are your sanctuary. The roar of the crowd is your prize. Yes, the roar of the crowd is your prize. Like a phoenix you rise from the ashes. To fight another day. And thoughts to the ones who have heard the last bell. To the brothers we've left behind. Lace up your gloves, you're a pugilist. Born and raised to survive. Blood, sweat and tears are your sanctuary. The roar of the crowd is your prize. I said the roar of the crowd is your prize. I said the roar of the crowd is your prize.